district tonight to perform for you. Sit back, relax. This is our beginning band. Our first piece is Oedipus. our last piece. Otherwise, I can say they have improved so much since September. Thank you for your hard work. It's always a pleasure working with you every day. Their last song is called Defender of Time.
Thank you.
awards for our second year kids. Most outstanding, Ava.
Thank you. The Hightower Hiawatha Trail, located in Georgia, was used by Native Americans as a trading route for hundreds of years. In addition, marking a former boundary between Cherokee and Creek lands, it was one of three major footpaths used in the area. The name Hiawatha is believed to be an annualized corruption of a Cherokee word, referring to the name of a trail and a large permanent settlement and town by the same name. Time has had many devastating effects on the trail. Its geography has changed a great deal due to events in recent history. Shortly after World War II, the Army Corps of Engineers built Lake Allatoona to serve several purposes, including flood control, water supply, and hydropower generation. The original bed of the Hiawatha River runs through the middle of the lake, which covers portions of the old Hightower Trail and the original city of Hiawatha. And 7th grade band presenting the song Hiawatha.
Thank you.
Gage Boyd.
Thank you.
Brittany Farr from Trumbull. Sixth grade from Trumbull.
Yeah, Grant.
Okay, we're for eighth grade band. We've been together for what, 4 years? Yeah, okay, so that's hard. You guys have done such a great job. All proud of you. Most outstanding, Carl Castle.
And we all fall out.
was Worksheet Wednesdays.
Thank you.
before we leave, we have our junior roast parade tomorrow, Wednesday. Don't forget, 9:30 your student class, Brewing Stack Lunch. We're excited to go. Thank you, everybody. I appreciate all the support. And a huge round of applause to the chaperones that have helped us this year.
We are resetting for our combined performance. This is your last chance to buy raffle tickets over at the table. If you want to do that, we'll draw right when this performance is done. Okay, I think we're ready. This is a fun tradition we haven't got to do, obviously, since 2019. And at the District Band Festival, obviously, you get to see like this progression from sixth grade beginning band all the way up to our graduating seniors this year. And this is always fun because this is kind of a sneak peek of what's to come next year. Because on stage, you see our eighth grade band combined with the high school symphonic band. And most of these folks will be members, in fact, almost all of them have forecasted, which is fantastic, have forecasted for band next year, so they'll be in this. So you're kind of seeing kind of a sneak peek of what you're gonna get next year. We faked you out in the program a little bit. We are doing a piece called In Canto, but it's not that In Canto. So yeah, it's not that. It's a piece from the 80s, and it's by Robert W. Smith. It's kind of a staple of the band, of the band world. And we have never rehearsed this together before. So, yeah, I do like to live dangerously, yes. So, sit back, relax, enjoy, say a good word for us. This is Robert W. Smith's In Canto with the 8th grade band and the high school symphonic band.
Thank you.
do our last big set change here. Eighth grade, I'm going to have you bring your chairs back to that room. And high school symphonic band, go ahead and move into the center here, and we will be right back. Well, we're going to start with a laugh over here. They jumped out, it must be the wind. So this is for one of the flower baskets, and the number is, oh God, I forgot my glasses, 381-9626. All right, the next number is 381-9623. That better not be you again. All right, last one for right now, 727-442. 727-442. Thank you. thank you all so much for coming out tonight, and especially everybody who's sticking around for the high school band. We really appreciate your support here. Middle school, what a fantastic performance. Thank you so much. Can't wait for you to be up here very soon. On stage is the Hockinson High School Symphonic Band. This band is made up of freshmen through seniors, and along with the wind ensemble and the percussion ensemble, we have been busy. I was trying to count since May 14th. They have done, and ending with graduation this Friday, I believe they will have done something like 9 or 10 performances. We did our benefit dinner, we did the Hazeldell Parade, we spent 5 days in Disneyland in Southern California performing, which was cool. We had a jazz band concert, we had 2 parades last Saturday, we've got this event, and we've got graduation on Friday. We crammed all this at the end of the year in hopes that the world would open up again so we could do it, and boy did it. So we're tired, and these guys have been working super hard, but it's a good kind of tired. I'm really proud. Every single concert that we're doing, just about every single concert performance, they're doing a new set of music. The stuff you're going to hear tonight, we usually spend, what, about 8 weeks working on music. It's more like 2. They've done just fantastic work. So this is, we're going to open up with an old standard. This is by the great George and Ira Gershwin. This is Strike Up the Band. For the symphonic band, for their portion, is entitled March and Procession of Bacchus. and it's got a very exciting conclusion. I hope you enjoy.
Folks, time for more raffles. Now we've got 381-9494. 381-9494. Hey, up in the top corner. We'll draw the other one quick so these guys can get back to business. And the last one is 381-9589. 9589. They have another one up there in the corner. No? All right, here we go. Come on down, guys.
So before we have our band perform here, there's a group of people that I absolutely have to thank, and that is our wonderful Hockinson High School Music Booster Club officers and volunteers. Can we get a hand for them?
job alone, and we have great support from our district, but we still can't do it all alone. There's more kids, there's 1 in 6 kids in this district are in band, which is a pretty crazy thing to think about. Yeah. It's not a competition, it's bigger than the football team. And it's just us. It's just good old JR and me. That's all that we get. And so the parent volunteers, Mrs. Rittenberg, thank the chaperones. We're going to be going to the Junior Rose Parade tomorrow. We can't do what we do. You know, we don't have tons of coaches and coordinators and all this kind of stuff. It's just us. And so the parents really go a long way to lighten the load. So I did just want to thank, just blanketly, all of the chaperones, all of the volunteers, as well as our music boosters. They worked tirelessly all year, but in May we had our annual benefit dinner concert auction, first one since 2019. And with their help and with your help, we raised over $40,000 for this music program. We do have a couple of senior booster officers who are graduating along with their children tonight, so I did want to recognize them real quick, and sorry, you got to come up here and be embarrassed. So first one would be our communications coordinator, which is Jen Teckenberg. So Jen, come on up. While she's on her way up here, I'd also like to get our Vice President of Student Activities, Sarah Abbott.
Yeah!
Along with the rest of the boosters, we just want to make sure that we thank you both for all of your service and dedication. They've been a part of the boosters through some pretty difficult times, as we're all been experiencing, and they've hung in there. They've found ways to make it enjoyable, found ways to make it exciting, and honestly, thanks to them and so many others, we really weathered the COVID storm pretty well. Our numbers are great. You hear the talent in our groups right now and all year. And I really mean it. I cannot do my job without these folks. And so, Jen and Sarah, thank you for all that time. She's not technically graduating. She's got a senior graduating tonight, but she's still got another one a couple of years down the line. But Megan Bruning, our band booster president, our fearless leader. They've been a great team. Megan's going to be around for a couple more years, and we're kind of like the mafia, where you don't really ever get out. So we'll still be calling on these guys too. But just one more round of applause for our class of 2020. All right, on with the show. This first piece we're going to open up with the wind ensemble. I don't do this very often, but we're featuring a soloist, and there's a little story behind this where I actually have my friend, the former band director at Washougal High School, Kelly Ritter, if you're watching at home, thank you for this, sends me this YouTube video, and she's like, look at this. And it's just this funny, cheesy marimba solo. And it's crazy. I think it's like a Brazilian band or something like that. And I show it to Kaisho, and actually she was subbing for me too. She showed it to Kaisho, and we're like, what do you think? Should we try this? And so I researched it, found an arrangement of it. He learned it. It's a piece entitled Sardis. And I've been telling the kids all week while we've been rehearsing it that it's cheese factor 11. But it's also, you're going to see why we are featuring Kaisho Barnhill, one of our senior band members here. He's done outstanding work on it. And this could be you one day. All right, we hope you enjoy the Wind Ensemble featuring Kaisho Barnhill on Sardis.
Thank you.
All right. Well, I think that was fun. We got more coming at you. But really, one more hand for Patrick Barnard. In 2019, Hockinson School District got a new superintendent, and one of the, how about that, by the way, the 1920 school year for a first year in the district. My hat's off to you, sir. Got a group of community members together to start planning a celebration for the 150th anniversary of the town of Hockinson and the Hockinson School District. And got the idea to commission a piece, which commissioning a piece means you hire a composer, and a composer writes a piece of music that is specifically dedicated to an important event or person, something like that. We got the process going, and then it happened. And it was kind of put on the back burner, and we've passed the 150th anniversary, but I'm gonna invite Superintendent Steve Marshall up here to talk a little bit about kind of the genesis of this project, and then what you're gonna hear tonight is a world premiere of a piece never been performed entitled Sesquicentennial Saga. So Superintendent Marshall, come on up here.
High school students, and good evening family members and community members. Again, my name is Steve Marshall. It's all in the timing. Again, an interesting leadership challenge, but it's been no less a challenge than Aisho stepping up and taking on the marimba, or any of the challenges that, especially our seniors, and so taking on over the past few years. So I want to say congratulations, seniors. You're an impressive group. Really admire your leadership and had a big impact on Hockinson High School and our community as a whole. So, you know, I came here to listen to music, and you just can't make it happen. I'm gonna have to give you a little backstory, and I'm sorry about that. But I think it will make the song a little more meaningful. So tonight, Hockinson High School Wind Ensemble is premiering a piece of music that has its origins here, nearby, and afar. And it draws inspiration from Hockinson's past and celebrating our present and our future. So I think it's pretty timely. Here's the brief history of how the song came about. Both our band director, Corey McHenry, and our composer of tonight's musical piece are products of Richard Mancini's band program at Camas High School, where I was the principal for 9 years until 2017. In 2012, I ended the year with a budget surplus, and that doesn't happen very often in education. And so I went to Mr. Mancini and said, what do you need to take your band program to the next level? And his response was, I need a sousaphone. So we bought a sousaphone, and that's important here, because coincidentally, that is the instrument that John Newman played for the next 4 years in the band. And he played it constantly. And when I would drive home from work, I would see him walking in the evenings, just stretch out his legs, you know, to kind of get tight, sitting all day and practicing so many hours. So John went on to major in music at the University of Washington. In anticipation of Hockinson's 150th anniversary in 2020, I contacted his family and they put me in touch with John. And here's what I shared. I shared PowerPoint presentation that I put together, kind of spanning 1870 to 2020. And here are some of the historical points. John, I'm not certain about this, but I believe the main Native American tribes in the area were Chinook and Cowlitz. The first European settlers were from Finland, and the main industries were logging, farming, and dairy farming. This is the timeline. Okay, I went back thousands of years, Native Americans. 1850 to 1860s, Finnish settlers arrived. 1870, Eureka School is constructed. 1890, town changes its name from Eureka to Hockinson. In 1893, Chinese laborers dig a ditch to drain the swampy agricultural areas, which is still to this day called China Ditch. Hockinson incorporated some other nearby schools, like Salmon Falls School District, and it took many forms throughout the 20th century. In 1968, Hockinson Elementary School was established In 2003, Hockinson High School was built. So what does this timeline leave you with? I'm speaking through my email to John. I don't know, I'm not sure. But I do, you can incorporate these different elements, or if there is a song that you can uncover and adapt to create a new, unique song that pays respect to the past and also has a really strong finish that speaks to a bright future that lies ahead, then that's the challenge. He took it on, did his research, wrote this piece, which has been sitting unplayed in Mr. McHenry's music archive for 2 years, so that adds to some mystery to this all, right? Beyond commemorating the 152-year history of Hockinson, I believe this song is a tribute to the knowledge, to the connections, and the relationships that are strengthened through education. Together, John's music, Mr. McHenry's instruction, and our students' performance will honor the generations of people who contributed to this census-designated place. That is Hockinson, that's what it is. But more than that, it is my hope that their collaboration inspires all of us. All of us come together and create a brilliant chapter in Hockinson schools and our community moving forward. So let it begin tonight with the Sesquicentennial, which is 150 year saga. And this song is a saga.
It is a saga.
And in 2 weeks, your students learned it. And so it's impressive, and we can't wait to hear it. So let's get to it.
Okay.
Thank you.
one more time. We have come to the end of our evening, and sadly, we must say goodbye to our seniors. And so, we have a little tradition here. Can I get all of the class of 2022 to come on up here and line up on the front of the stage? All right, class of 2022, our 15 senior band members of the class of 2022. They've been through a lot. They have been tested as leaders, as musicians, as human beings. And if our future is in their hands, I feel pretty good about our future. You're not gonna find a better group of people. And after working with them, some of them in middle school, fifth grade even, high school obviously for 4 years, or sometimes, in some cases, just this 1 year, they've all left a mark on us, they've all left a mark on me, and they're like my own kids. We're gonna miss them dearly. So I do have a little token of our appreciation that I will give you, that I need to, that's right there. Seniors, I do have a class of 2022 band pin that you can put on your tassels and all of that for graduation, so we hope that you wear this with pride. So let's go ahead and go down the line. First of all, just in no particular order, because they're right here, how about Madeline Lyon? So Madeline joined me as a sophomore. She moved here from California, was a violin player, and I'm like, I don't have anything for you here. But she really wanted to be in a music program, and I said, well, do you play anything? Well, she plays piano, and she can read music. I'm like, we're putting you in the percussion ensemble. You're gonna do a great job in there. Never played drum in her life. Got in there, was one of the hardest workers that I've ever had, and had never settled for anything less than her best. And by her senior year, she's every bit as good as anybody else in that section. And it's all because of her hard work and her dedication, which is gonna go a long way. She's gonna go to college, she's gonna keep playing music. So probably a lot more violin than percussion, but I think you'll get some in there. And she's just an absolute sweetheart. So Madeline, thank you, we're gonna miss you. And then there's Max Barrow. Yeah, all right. Max Barrow is, there is not a room that Max Barrow walks into that doesn't immediately get more funny. He's a great person, a big personality, has really been kind of thrown into some leadership roles here as our principal clarinet player, was also our drum major, and has really, really shined through all of that. And I am going to miss our daily banter, but he is going to go on to do great things. You're going to the Great White North, right? To Alaska? Okay. So he's going to do great things. By the way, I also wanted to mention, sorry, Max, I'm going to step on your thunder here a little bit, but his dad, Matt Barrow, has been a chaperone extraordinaire for us. While not technically a booster officer, he pretty much is in all but titles. So thank you, Matt, for that. And thank you, your best contribution to the band was this man right here, Max Barrow. Tyler Jardine is right next to him. Tyler joined me just this year, moved from my hometown of Camas, and so we've been able to bond a little over that, but is a multi-talented person. He's also a fire cadet, and when we were talking before he was moving here, we were saying, well, fire cadet doesn't really work with wind ensemble, where I thought he really should be, and he goes, I'll do symphonic, and I just want to be band. And he's been a rock star tuba player. Could not have done it without him. And I mean this in the best possible way, while you've only been here for a year, I feel like you've been here a lot longer. And so I'm gonna miss you, and it's been great getting to know you, Tyler. So thank you. Tony Abbott's right there. And that's enough of that. Annabella Horsley. I'm allowed to be a little bit mean to her because she'll throw it right back at me too. Chloe is one of the nicest, most genuine people that you'll know. And I've had the pleasure of knowing Chloe for a long time. My daughter went to her house to be babysat when she was just a toddler before she was in school. And so, again, Chloe, it kind of feels like you really are one of my kids. And watching you grow and watching you, you know, just become a great person, great musician, it's gonna be, you're leaving a big hole here. And I thank you for all of the years, and thought goodbye and see you later, all right? So, Chloe Abbott. How about Annabella Horsley on the flute? Don't cry, dear. You are sunshine. You are sunshine personified. This girl is just the best. We can geek out together over Disney stuff. I had a blast with her just a couple weeks ago. It's been it was a memorable trip down there. But you've been in with the ensemble since a freshman, right? So she's been in all 4 years, which is quite the accomplishment. And a great leader, and like I said, I know I sound like a broken record here that she's a great person, but it really is true. I mean, you're the best. So Annabella, thank you, congratulations to you, and we'll see you soon. Jasmine Grant is next on clarinet. Jasmine. So Jasmine moved here. Did you move here as a freshman or a sophomore? As a freshman from Gresham, I believe, right? Yeah. And if I could give somebody the Bootstraps and Most Improved Award, it would definitely be Jasmine. She's absolutely the best possible connotation of band nerd, and that is a term of endearment around here. She is, she loves band, she's all about it, she's always here. She has worked her tail off to be a crucial member of our wind ensemble, a sweet person, and I'm gonna miss you a lot, and I'm glad that we had our 4 years together, so thank you. Kate Stenerson on the flute, it's Kate. A man of few words, Kate Stenerson, stoic even, we might say, but Kate is a character, and he's a great hard worker, along with Annabella in the flute section. Kate and Annabella have been great leaders in there, and Kate is multi-talented in terms of, you know, athletics, and he does great stuff with, he's able to balance school with Running Star. Are you in Running Star right now? Yeah, so a perfect example of how you can do band and fill in the blank. Kate always makes it work, and he's a talent, and he's a great person, and I thank you, Kate. Parker Brooming on the alto saxophone. Parker. Parker's a freak. I mean that in the best possible way. He's one of those people who does incredible work, and then I get to take all the credit for it. I don't have to do anything with Parker. Parker, I can give him music, and he's got to learn. I can, whether it's jazz band, whether it's wind ensemble, pit orchestra, marching band, pep band, it doesn't matter. He does it all, and is leaving a really big shoes to fill. Parker was our winner of the Louis Armstrong Jazz Award, which is a nationally recognized award that I can only give to one senior. Gave it to him last week at our district jazz night. He absolutely earned it. Has won tons of soloist awards at everything that we go to, and again, just a great person, great leader, and can't wait to see where you go after this, because it's gonna be good. Parker, thank you. Right next to him, never far behind, is Owen Teckenberg on the tenor saxophone right now. So Owen is, again, another multi-talented person. He plays tenor in here. He's playing alto sax in the jazz band, where he's been a section leader in there and has done just really good things. Again, if I give him a piece of music, I know it's going to be learned. In fact, we're doing like an impromptu jazz band performance tomorrow in our commons, just as like our one last, it's kind of like our equivalent of the Beatles rooftop performance. It's our farewell concert. And he's still in the practice room today working out kinks in some of his music so he can play his solo even better. And I'm like, we're just gonna be playing for people eating breakfast. Like, they might not even be listening to it, but he's gonna do it. He's gonna work on it until it's great. And that's a great quality to have, and it's gonna take you far in life. And so thank you for everything you've done for us. Next on the euphonium is Eden Hastings. Eden has played many different things. Started out on baritone, and then I said, I need a tuba player. And said, I'll do tuba. So switched over to tuba, did great work there, switched back to baritone. I was like, never mind, I actually need a baritone the next year, and has done just fantastic work. A great soloist, a great leader, has been a band council officer for numerous years, and so has taken on some great leadership roles, and just an all-around great person. So thank you so much for everything you've done. Kayla Cedillo is right next to Eden. Kayla, wave to the people. Yes. So when we were in COVID lockdown, this is a little story about Kayla, we put a little recruitment video together, and Kayla had my favorite line in the video because their assignment was, tell me in 5 seconds or less something that you think eighth graders would appreciate and would want to join band because they heard it. And I put this whole compilation video together. And sitting at her computer, throws the shades on, the coolest kids in school are the band kids. I will never forget that. It will stay with me for life. So congratulations, you have left a legacy here. Because the coolest kids in school are the band kids. And next to Kayla is Hayden Newell. Hayden. Master's degree, yeah. All right. So Hayden Newell, a fantastic percussionist. I would give Hayden my Silent But Deadly Award. he is, sorry, it's not like that, so. He is a man of few words, but he is an absolute talent and a great leader in the percussion section. Has been our drumline captain this year, and again, one of those people where if I give him a piece of music, I know it's going to be learned. And not only that, but he will help other people out as well, and is a very selfless person. And that's a great quality, again, to have. You learn more than music in band. You learn life skills that are going to take you a long way. And he has demonstrated that in addition to being a fantastic percussionist, he is going to be an outstanding human being. It already is, but it's going to get better, too. So, Hayden, congratulations to you. Thank you. Ethan Shu on the Barry saxophone is next. I don't know, Ethan, I think that like my ears are gonna not ring as much next year because it's gonna be so much quieter in the band room. He is a fantastic player, one of the loudest players that I've ever had. And that's, again, it's most of the time a good thing, but I'm sure you're tired of getting the hand of, you know, most of the time. But he is a fantastic player, a great sense of humor, has been, was a great, how many years were you in jazz? Were you in all 4 years? Yes, okay. He was all 4 years in jazz band on Barry saxophone, which is an incredibly important role to be playing there, and is just, as you can see, quite the character, and never a dull moment when Ethan is around. So Ethan, thank you for everything that you've done. Would you just look at the smile on Keegan Conrad right here? Just look at him. Isn't he the cutest? I love him. Keegan is, again, just like the nicest person. And he has been, he's somebody who has come back to us when he realized how much he missed band and has been, came right back to Wind Ensemble, got right to work, and has been an integral part of this trumpet section, probably one of the hardest working trumpet sections that I've had. And thanks to his leadership and thanks to a lot of his hard work, coming in extra hours and always being willing to do whatever it takes. There's been years where I said, here, he can play the mellophone. Okay, I'll play the mellophone. Now he's back on trumpet because that's where I needed him this time. So I appreciate his flexibility and all of his hard work there. So Keegan, thank you. And at the very end there, you already heard from earlier, Kaisho Barnhill, our percussionist. Kaisho came in as a freshman, having not gone to Hockinson before, came in and blew everybody out of the water. And from freshman year on, just really, just floored me. It's something he's got that I just get to step back as a teacher and just say, no, you just keep doing that. You do that, absolutely. But also the amount of dedication he has to this program. He's here more than anybody else. He is helping other students out. He's running sectionals, he's coaching, he's even coming in after school or during seventh period and working with my fifth grade percussionists on their stuff. And he eats, sleeps, and breathes band, which when he got here, it was soccer, so I win. sorry, Craig, his dad. But he has, there's no one like him, and there won't be another Kaisho. He's a fantastic person. And look at your future, because he's decided to go on to the University of Washington to major in music education and become a band director. So. Anyways, this is your class of 2022. Let's give them a hand. I also have one award I do want to give at the concert, and that is the John Philip Sousa Band Award. Again, this is a nationally recognized award that I'm allowed to give to one graduating senior for demonstrating superb musicianship, leadership, and character. And while I could give it to all 15 of these folks for all of the work, when it came down to it, I really had to give it to one person, and that is Kaisho Barnhill. Trombone on the stage, and all of my seniors and myself are wearing this pin. We have a member of the class of 2022 who is not with us, and that is Brendan Lefevre. And Brendan was tragically killed in a car accident at the very end of last summer, and the band room never was quite the same. There, again, nobody like Brendan Lefevre, the nicest kid you will ever meet in your life. Loved band, absolutely loved it. He was all about band, and while you know he did other great things, he was beloved in the school. Whether he was with the football team or with the band, he was at home here. This was his home, and he was our symphonic band brass section leader. His peers voted him into that role in our band council, and he was meeting with us this summer to plan out band camp, and I believe it was later that evening he was gone. And it was quite a shock to all of us. It's something that I don't think I'll ever get over, I don't think any of us will, and we've kind of dedicated our entire year this year to Brendan during our football season, when we've got the trombones down there on the sidelines, the third quarter doing their thing. They always had Brendan's trombone and his hat right there. And he'll always be here. He'll always be right here. And we hope that tonight as we finish up here with a tradition that we have, which is the singing of You'll Never Walk Alone. We know that he is here along with us as well. And so if you would like to join our seniors and our band, who while I've been yammering on up here, has reset. We have our whole band program up here right now for a performance of You'll Never Walk Alone. And so the words are on the back of your program if you'd like to join with us. And thank you so much to the class of 2022. Here we go.
Thank you.
Thank you all so much for coming out. Thank you for treating these seniors with the respect they deserve. I know it goes on long, but you'll love it when it's your kid too. So we thank you so much. What? Okay, so in Mr. McHenry's office, there are a couple of toolkits. They're generally used just for percussion maintenance and stuff like that, and there's been stuff missing from them for like decades. But every single time he goes to open one of those toolkits to fix like a percussion thing, he goes, "Kaisho, why is this missing?" As if he's surprised. It hasn't been there for years. So, just so that our next drumline captain, Blake Broom, Blake Wade, just so he doesn't have to deal with the same thing, we got him a brand new toolkit with an extra drum key in it, just to remind you that it's from us.
Henry talks a lot, and since I've been with him for 4 years, there's obviously a lot of interesting things that come out of his mouth, such as Parker's a freak, and you heard Cheese Factor 11. So, from all of the years, we have compiled a bunch of quotes. For example, y'all want some cookies?
We got the classic Don't Do Stupid Things.
And we also have Against My Better Judgment, I Will Now Call on Max.
Yes. Our bonus quote, which is, these quotes are making me sound like a Soviet.
So yeah, thank you for all this. Cheers.
Last quote, and in my opinion, I said quote, last gift, in my opinion, the best gift too. This is like some legit stuff, Academy Award level item. We were sent an Oscar for the best teacher.
For pictures, I release everybody now. Nothing else. All right, thank you, everybody. Have a great summer. We'll see you in the fall.